Right, so Trig Quiz 5 is all really about trig graphing, which you got a taste of in last night's Ed Puzzle video. So what I want to start by doing today is talking about some of the Ed Puzzle results from last night, because there were a few misconceptions. Once we're done with that, we're going to get into, this is on page 21, 22 in the packet, so have that out so we can jump right in and do some more trig graphing, okay? All right, so from last night's Ed Puzzle, one of the questions that was open-ended with your responses here was, what transformation occurs due to the negative sign in the equation y equals negative 4 sine x? And can you remind me, somebody raise your hand and tell me, what is the correct answer to that? So because of the negative in the equation, what really happens to the graph of sine x there? Yes, Emma, what do you think? Yeah, the true answer is that this is a reflection over the x-axis. So I can see why one of our answers, I don't know if you guys can quite see it, but it says one of the answers was reflect over the y-axis. So we knew that it was some sort of reflection, but can somebody tell me what the equation would look like if it got reflected over the y-axis? What do you think about that? If I was going to reflect over y, how would that change the way the equation looks? Stan, what do you think?
Negative x?
Yeah, the x would be negated on the inside. So if I said 4 sine of negative x, that would actually make it reflect over y. Okay. Alright, and then what about the other answer, which was shrink? Shrink was not necessarily a bad answer, because when you think about maybe a negative being out front, maybe that would change the size of the graph in a way that shrinks it. Okay. But what kind of number would have to be out front to really produce a shrink? Raise your hand and give me an example of a number that could shrink it, Allie. A decimal or a fraction, right? Something between 0 and 1 out front here produces a vertical shrink. So the 4 actually does the vertical stretch, but a vertical shrink would be something between 0 and 1. Okay, the other question that was asked of you, the multiple choice, was, what is the period of y equals 2 sine of 4x? And here are the different multiple choice to choose from. We had a few people choose 2 pi, some people choose pi. The correct answer is pi over 2, and the wrong answer at the end here, some people chose pi over 4. So if you remember how to compute the period, I need somebody to help me with that. Erica, what do you think?
You do 2 pi, and then you put it over the frequency.
Good. Period is defined as 2 pi divided by the frequency, and the frequency in this example is 4. So 2 pi divided by 4 does reduce to pi over 2, which is why this is the correct answer right here. Now, I can see why you would have chosen some of those other examples. If you just chose 2 pi, maybe it's because you were thinking the period equation has something to do with 2 pi. The reason why a multiple choice of pi might have been chosen is maybe that's like 2 pi over 2, which was the amplitude, but not the frequency. And then pi over 4, maybe you just forgot it was 2 pi over, and you just did pi over. So some other ways to come up with those answers. Can somebody describe to me what the period represents for a trig graph? It's a pretty important value in my opinion, because it tells me a lot about the graph. Allie, what do you think? Yeah, it's something to do with the cycle, right? So the 4 would tell me that there are 4 cycles of the graph by the time I get to 2 pi, which means that pi over 2 is the amount of time it takes to do what?
1 cycle.
Complete 1 cycle. And that will be a huge focus in this unit, is how long does it take to complete 1 cycle? Many of the directions moving forward will say to sketch 1 cycle of the graph. So you'll see that actually in the video coming up this weekend. We will see sketch 1 cycle, and it's going to be highly dependent on what the period is. And then guess when we get to recap that video? Monday, of course, but what's Monday?
Pi Day!
Pi Day on Monday. Best math day ever. It happens to be my anniversary, too, which is purely coincidental. I don't have enough funds to buy you all pie. If you buy one for me, I'll probably eat some. Anyway. Alright, so that's good for Ed Puzzle from last night. Let's go to the packet on page 22. Page 22. Okay,
I'm doing notes.
Did you recall from Algebra 2 last year what the graphs of sine and cosine looked like?
Yeah.
Remember those? Okay, perfect. So what we're using right now is the calculator to generate some of these graphs, but keep in mind the goal for the end of this unit is to be able to graph them without using the calculator at all. So we're learning and recalling some of the transformations that occur when I, in this example, add a constant out front, right? When we multiply by that value in general A, which I've called the amplitude, this should have been representative. This was covered in the video. It was a vertical dilation. And those are the conditions for stretch versus shrinking the graph. I asked you to try that example in your notes, y equals negative 4 sine x. If you have not attempted that yet, please make a quick sketch of it now and then check with your groupmates to see did they have the same sketch as you. Discuss. We're going to go over this in 1 minute, so real quick. Okay, sketch it if you didn't already and then check with your groups, see what they get. If you feel like you're in a place where you can do that, sure.
Okay.
And if you think that would help, because I've given you, oh, you're saying like for this current unit?
Yeah.
In theory, yes. If you feel like that's not going well, I'll give you more copies of this.
Okay.
Is that okay?
Yeah, I didn't watch the one.
That's okay.
Last one,
but. All right. That's fine. All right, you guys keep working, check in with each other in a moment here.
Thanks. I mean, it's being good.
Yeah. What's up?
So I get that it reflects, but why is it? You
I know.
Okay. So if you have two of them, you're on the wrong page. That's
I gotta write them. Oh, yeah. All
right, so we've all confirmed here.
Yes.
The same graph.
I told her she was on the wrong page.
That's okay.
We're good.
All
right,
good.
Okay.
Yeah, show that we're having. Thanks, Rob. Just like Kelly. Love you.
We all have the same graph. You guys are great. Okay. Let me check in on you guys over here.
So I'm always the best teacher ever.
Guys, I think Okay, we have some different looking graphs over here.
Yeah, I have that.
You don't know where that came from?
No, I happened yesterday.
Well, Sam says you did cosine, not sine. What do you think about that?
I don't think I was thinking when I did that.
That's okay. We can start thinking about it now.
Yeah. Thank you. Why? We get the alchemy. Mr. All, you said everything so far.
That's okay. Did you two get matching graphs? Is that good? Okay. Did you originally have this and then you changed it? That's the negative. Perfect. Okay. Alright, let's take a look at what we've got. So, y equals. Alright, bring it on up here. Negative 4 sine x. We know that the sine curve, traditionally, okay, has x-intercepts at 0 pi and 2 pi over that interval. And the negative and the 4 do two different things, right? So if I ask you to tell me the amplitude, the only thing I want you to be cautious about is that the amplitude is the absolute value of that number out front. I'm not sure if I defined it that way in the video, but it's very typical of students to say that the amplitude is negative 4. The amplitude is just 4. Okay, go ahead, Ian. Correct. If there's nothing like formally written out front, we would say that the amplitude is 1 and use that as part of our sketch. Absolutely. All right, so then the negative out front, we know that that reflects now over the x-axis, which was the question from Ed Puzzle last night. We discussed that earlier. So therefore, I need to mark off where negative 4 and positive 4 are on the y-axis, because that 4 is going to be that vertical stretch of the sine curve. So instead of starting by going up to its max height, right? I mean, if you look at the 3 sine x and compare it, sine usually